Hi, the JPW platform provides component models to assemble and deploy our applications. The three important component models are JAR, VAR, and EAR. Today, from this presentation, you will learn what a JAR file is and why and how to use it. JAR stands for Java Archive. It is a container of Java beans, also known as simple Java classes. JAR files were first introduced to support applets. Applets were Java programs that run on your browser's JVM. Applets can be embedded within a HTML page, and then your browser can pull this applet off the server and run it on the browser's JVM. When a particular applet uses a lot of classes to perform a particular function, instead of downloading one class at a time from the server, we can bundle them within a JAR file and deliver this JAR file to the browser, which can then perform what the applet has to do. We can create a JAR file using the JAR command that comes with JDK. It has multiple options. The options I have here is CVF, which stands for create a JAR file in verbose mode, give us all the details, what's happening behind the scenes, and then F for file, tells the JAR command where the output should go, in this case my.jar, and the list of classes which has to go into this JAR file. In IDEs like Eclipse or NetBeans, we can export our Java projects very easily into a JAR file. And when you compile your classes and package them from within Ant or any other build tool, you can use the appropriate JAR tasks provided by these build tools. A JAR file also has a meta manifest.mf file under the meta.inf folder within it. This file lists all the contents of a JAR file. We can make a JAR file an executable JAR file by creating a class with a main method, adding this class to a particular JAR file, and then listing that class with the main method using the main class attribute within the manifest.mf. Once we do that, we can double click on the JAR file to run it, or we can even run that JAR file from command line using the Java command, just like you run any other Java classes which has the main method. The only difference is you use a hyphen JAR option and provide the JAR file name. So to make a JAR file an executable JAR file, you first create a class with a main method, add the class to the JAR, and then list that class along with the packaging structure in the main class attribute within manifest.mf file. If our JAR depends on other classes from other JAR files to perform its function, then we can add these dependencies to the manifest.mf using class path attribute and listing all the dependencies separated by space. In summary, you now know what a JAR file is. It is a container of Java classes. It can be used to bundle a lot of classes together. A JAR file can have a manifest file under the meta.inf directory, which is helpful in multiple ways. One, we can make a JAR an executable JAR by listing it using the main class attribute. Two, we can add any dependencies for our JAR file using the class path attribute and listing all the JARs that particular JAR depends on. Another variation of a JAR file is a VAR file, which stands for Web Archive, which bundles multiple JAR files along with JSPs and servlets and other web components together. You will learn more about a VAR file in the next presentation. Until then, take care. Thanks for watching.